will break with time. But time is of the essence. I don't have time. Will time help you survive the heavens blaze like the stone ages? Because I am afraid. Will time help you survive the heavens blaze of the revolution and the revelations? No, it won't. Is time enough to bless the young children with the truth? No, it's not. But it's enough for your heart to whisper the secrets that you couldn't even hide. Your heart is strong enough to go through the pain of a thousand nights and not strong enough to love me? I don't know what to do in this case because you are judging me because of my sexuality. But you do the same thing. I think it's rather safe to walk the pathway that has led me to my deathbed, rather than love you.
Call me Aubrey Bond. We talked for a while. He asked how long it was. A couple centuries I applied to this distasteful sense of regret, continuing to exchange pointless words until finally he asked, am I people again? He knows the answer, yet he still asks the question. Why? Is that a pity for us, or is he trying to help himself fight this from guilt? I stare at him, set him straight in the eyes. I see something I wasn't getting for the first day during the boxing. Something I thought I couldn't have missed before. I saw guilt. Sorry. I heard shouts. I heard with a hustle. I can't decipher what came from behind here, behind him, easily mistakenly. The type of people had lost their way, so kind of voices making the people to be happy if I heard it again. With a hustle. This time, look what it means. Careful. Why? All of a sudden, I felt the blade touch my neck. It was too late. But I touched him before I touched him. But I touched him before he took advantage. But when I sent you before there is no resistance, I know the outward resistance. Death. As I'm driving away, I still can't help but wonder if what I saw in his eyes was guilt. I wondered if the man that betrayed me felt guilt. I guess that's why I remembered for my kind of useful ways, while he's remembered for the killing of our people and taking from that. That's why I remember as a man who led my tribe to infiltrate, and he is remembered as a man who served Florida. I am Aubrey Bond, the man who led his tribe to death. He is Ponce de Leon, the man who led his tribe to discovery and success.
Call me Manco Inca. I was ruler of the great Inca Empire, pawn of the Spanish Emir Sul, mocked, beaten, robbed by the people who took my land, my wife, taking my mother's Spanish. I quivered. Quivering was all I could do. This illusion of power tricked me to believe I could be something more. I controlled over 100,000 men, as if the wrestling of fate was choking them into the oblivion face of my orders. Orders that would lead me to my own regretful defeat. Their clothes disheveled beyond repair, beyond repair, beyond repair. I soon realized that the Spanish, there were no friends. Their spitting on me was not human. They craved for more, raping my people, taking our land. None of this was equivalent to the power I had. Power was only a title I had. This was all I had. Today I gasped for rebellion, and today I ache for change. I have called for warriors from every scraper of men which is mine in name, but no longer mine in truth. Rallied up over 100,000 men. Drunk of this, I blindly ordered my men. The end was at our fingertips. A silent will that had pulled and pushed me had not yet faltered. Its faith risk demanded more, and more is what it had achieved. My men rallied again. The false power that I once had and sheathed itself and began to rise. Call me Montezuma. I was viewed as a godlike entity. My sun bronze skin was a rich flavor of my culture. It was a world wonder that was my title. My name was gifted to me by a king and given to me by my father, Akakaten. He was the one of many kings before me. However, he was nothing like me, for I was far more superior. I moved from the temples where I was worshipped, from the rich lands of Mexico, to a condo that I brought in New York. At the hands of my conquerors, I was advised to pray from Mutila Pochti to our Lady Guadalupe, and eventually marry in her family, as long as I remembered to bring the weekly offering. At the same hands of my conquerors, I was advised to change my name from Montezuma to Montgeremoni, whichever name was easier to say. As I walked into this new false identity, I could feel my sense of pride, my sense of heritage, and my sense of integrity diminishing by the second. And all because it was so simple and friendly advice.
Mayor Nestor Che Guevara. Yeah. I've seen black things on this earth. But see, here's the funny thing about colors. On this earth, at least, they can change, they can rearrange. But see, men are blind to the color black. And when the sand under their own feet gets darker, they dissolve into their own naked selves. See, only when they die do they realize their corpses only make the black sand stronger. And here I sit, under this green wood tree, my hands pockmarked green from rubbing a tree all night long. But you see, there is no blood. And only then do I realize, how can corpses of red blood make black sand stronger? Unless I've been blind all this time, and I grab my motorcycle from the ferry, ride along the edges of rivers that I've seen before, ride on top of sand that I've seen before, see men that I've seen before, see! The scorched, hungry faces of small beings, their faces turned dark, their faces turned dark, black from seeing the sun all too bright, with dark dreams not too far from their own lack of sight. And only then do I realize, I've never seen this. Not the hungry miners, no, I've seen them before, but not. I never saw the caked in faces of a hungry child, the living, the breathing soul shoved out of them like mud. I never saw that. And I step off my motorcycle, and every time that I step on a new fleck of sand, I trip over myself, hitting my face hard on the corpses of my brothers long before me. And as I run my hand across this sand, the touch of tears that have long since dried out sting my very soul. No man is safe on this sand. No man is safe given the eyes of another. No man is safe serving the dreams of another, wishing the wishes of another. No man is safe living in a life made for him. And only then do I realize that I too have been given the eyes of another man, serving the dreams of another man, wishing the wishes of another man. And only then do I realize that I too have been infected. Wishes filled so black with soot that they can paint this entire night sky. So why not make the stars light up farther while we're at it? Thank you.